February 5th, 2010, a single gunshot from the halls of Discovery Middle School induces panic. 14-year-old Todd Brown's life ended shortly after Hammad Memon fired one shot to the back of Brown's head. The motive is cloudy at best. Mental health experts testified that Memon was afraid of his own gang-related activity. He thought that killing Brown was his only way out of the quote-unquote gang. Police never found any true links to serious outside gangs at Discovery. 2 years later, in 2012, while out on bond, Memon and his mother are captured in Dallas, Texas at a bus stop attempting to leave the country. Both Memon's parents pleaded guilty to hindering prosecution. They never truly served time, and probation was lifted as they returned back home to Pakistan. In 2013, Memon pleaded guilty and was sentenced to 30 years in prison. He addressed the court saying, in part, "I would like to beg the family of Todd Brown to forgive me." It's 2020 now. Discovery Middle has seen class after class of students move on in life. One of those former students, Hannah Manis, was one of the students placed on lockdown.
Students walk arm in arm with their parents away from Discovery Middle School, obviously shaken from the day's events.
It was very scary for us.
Hannah Manis describes the lockdown that happened seconds after the shooting.
Turn off all the lights. We got in the corner, locked the doors.
Watching that, what goes through your mind in that moment?
Just thinking that I somehow processed that and was able to talk to someone, I think it just shows that you can run off adrenaline and kind of be shocked and confused, and I didn't know anything at the time.
Manis has only watched this interview once. On occasion, Manis flashes back to the experience, mostly when she drives by the school or when she hears of another school shooting.
I don't know if I'd pushed it out of my mind or if I'd tried to just forget that it happened, but 10 years was, it hasn't felt like 10 years.
I thought I could control everything. The Lord really humbled me being the superintendent.
Outgoing Madison City School Superintendent Robbie Parker was principal at Bob Jones High School when the shooting occurred. Parker says school security when he was principal was not top of mind. He says those days are now over.
Every day I worry about our children every day. I worry about their safety. I worry about everything in the schools. Very frankly, it's almost a burden that I will say is almost unmanageable.
The Discovery shooting served as a catalyst for security change in the Madison City School District.
We got 11 schools and we've got 11 SROs now. We have a mental health counselor that services every single school. We've hired a full-time safety and security coordinator, Dr. David West. That's all he does.
Text to Protect was launched district-wide after the shooting. The tips go directly to police and the administrators. The program even stopped someone with a gun outside of Discovery Middle School years later.
We get a lot of texts to protect. Thankfully, 99% are not something that are life-threatening.
As the district, community, and the Brown family navigates their futures post-shooting, Hammad Memon is too.
Memon could be facing parole in about 6 years. He's scheduled to serve 30 years. His family no longer resides in the United States, and he himself may no longer be a U.S. citizen, putting deportation on the table. When I asked the family, they couldn't really tell me what they thought about that situation, but others did weigh in.
I believe in our legal system.
I have faith in the justice system. I believe that's the least that they can do for the family who has lost someone so special for them.
I called, was able to get a hold of Todd Brown's grandmother. We talked and she agreed. Consequences have actions. 10 years later, they're looking at photos of Todd and wondering, what would he be doing? What would he be like? Questions that don't have an answer. They were sure to remind me that there isn't a day that goes by where they don't think of what could have been.
Reporting in Madison, Ethan Fitzgerald, WHNT News 19.